Time for what?
Time for what?
Experience in college.
Time for reinforcement.
Time for liftoff!
Where nothing is impossible unless you think it is impossible.
College scholarship.
Yes. Boom.
College ran by real fast.
You hung in with the best college.
Touchdown! First time for everything.
Well, what are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?
Let's do this thing.
Genius, let's do this thing!
All right, welcome to the show, everyone. Thank you for listening, subscribing. Don't forget to subscribe, so you can listen to other podcasts. This is going to be one of the most interesting, exciting, nerve-wracking. And if you listen to this podcast, take the tips. It won't need to be that stressful. But if you don't, your neighbor who's not subscribed to this podcast, not following the recommended suggestions, may get a little bit stressed out because there's so many changes. But let's just follow that serenity prayer. You haven't heard the serenity prayer? The serenity prayer is, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, to have the courage to change the things I can, and have the wisdom to know the difference. And guess how you can make a difference? You can make the difference about making a statement about who you are. Now, that statement is so important. Beyond college, beyond a job interview, beyond even not disrespecting the family, even families, because you need to make a statement in black and white, people. Yes, I'm talking to you about who you are, how you are great despite your failures, how you have awesome powers because of your differences, and how have your thoughts and ideas have been amazing. But guess what the problem is? Unfortunately, in education, we don't spend a lot of time in first-person writing. Heck, we don't even spend that much time for students to get in front and talk about their stories without being, I don't know, how many times you've seen a movie where a kid talks about their story and people make fun of them? I mean, let's be honest. Sometimes the world could be cruel and not understanding. And then you're supposed to be able to go and tell a stranger, many strangers, colleges and universities, about who you are, what are your thoughts, what's going on? Yeah, you do. And welcome to feeling like a politician. Welcome to feeling like anyone doing a job interview. This is your interview on paper. And I love what I do for a living. And this is the part I love the most. It gives you the opportunity to tell your mind, your soul, and your spirit what makes you great. So, hey, let's put on that hat on. Let's shred that part of your heart so you could be honest, not modest, and let's figure out some brainstorming techniques for you to how to start this process, because there have been many podcasts, people, from the UCs, private schools, you name it, about what colleges are looking at, what not to do. Okay, that's been covered. You can find that in so many places, but how do you start? Well, the key thing is, hey, start writing right now. The key thing, my point is start writing. Regardless of whether you're about outline, lists, bullets, free writing, you name it, just start writing and create a schedule to write and make several drafts of your statements. Yeah, guess what? When presidential speeches are made, it's not the first rough draft. You should, if you're a great, good writer, maybe 3 or 4 drafts. Yeah, even for the good writers. If writing is a struggle, it may be 6 to 7. And that's from working with thousands of students from various different backgrounds, you name it. And that's okay. That's okay. That doesn't mirror your abilities. But you shredding your outer skin to showing your vulnerability, I'm not talking about the hardship. I'm just talking about being real. That takes courage, right? That's part of that serenity prayer, right? The courage to know the difference. So let's talk about some techniques to help you. So If you are free riding, just start riding whatever that topic is. Remember, on Common App, as was mentioned on past podcasts, it's a topic of your choice. Even the University of California has a topic of your choice. Just start riding. And then just make sure that as you go back and to edit, don't edit it right away. Walk from away from it. Give it a day, let's sleep over a night and look at it and find a trusted adult or a trusted person that understands the process. Because remember, you're not writing for you. You're not writing for that English teacher. You're writing to a college admissions person to convey to them, right, what makes you great to be a future student in the classroom, a future club member on their campus, a future roommate, a future alumni. Yeah, that's what it comes down to. And this is just one piece of many. It's not your only piece. So just write and make sure always go back. How is this reader interpreting? How are they understanding that? How do you find that out as free writing? Hey, after you write it, maybe record yourself. Yeah, even on your cell phone, hear it back and then think about how it sounds, right? Not the pitch or your voice, but just your words. Are you coming through? Do you sound like yourself? Yes, use your voice. This is not an English paper. The grammar, the syntax needs to be there, but just be real. Have a conversation with them that is also respectful, just for those who may have more colorful language. If free writing is not for you and that is not for everyone, then listen bullets, right? Brainstorming can be the simplest version, just jotting down ideas. Sometimes some students like, I don't know where to stop. Then I start and I said, okay, in your high school life, what have been the most positive and negative things that you've been involved in or things that have impacted you? And I said, just talk. And I would just write down after like a minute or two of them just saying, like, whether it be a certain sport, a job, an internship, family responsibilities, a certain club, an experience, reading a certain book. Yeah, you name it, right? Watching a show, an intellectual idea, how they feel about mosaic paintings, you name it. It's been all those colorful, wonderful things. And then I would say to them, highlight two things, maybe three, that you're the most passionate about, right? Not the most impactful, but the thing that's your most passionate. The reason why I say that, because you want something you're going to be able to write and then rewrite and re-edit over and over again. That's your ticket there, right? And if it's a topic of your choice, answer that. If not, figure out the topic. If it's a lesson that you learn, focus on those two or ideas that answer that, etc. The creative topic, you name it. But just make sure you are answering that prompt that is presented to you. Now, there's other techniques you'll hear about, like starbursting, like brainstorming on that, mind mapping. There's a lot of different techniques that it's used. You know, I've even had, if you have a good friend or another adult out there who could just kind of outline for you, like, why is this important? What are some other things and ideas that you want to do? You want to make sure that your ideas have a flow and a connections. Like, what are the points you want? So sometimes an outline can kind of point out, what do you want them to know? I'm hardworking. Okay. So that's the idea. So show the reader, don't tell the reader how you are hardworking. Give them concrete examples, right? And then as you create your outline, your ideas, the free writing. After you get those paragraphs out there, don't worry about your introductions until the end, right? Then you could start asking a question and you share a shocking, amusing fact. Don't do a quote. Oh my God, I still remember senior graduation where we had a wonderful person who was our valedictorian who did a speech and all she did was quote. We had no original ideas. The colleges want to hear about you. And don't make it a dramatized scene that's focusing on a family or a mentor or somebody else. Remember, they're looking about learning about you, right? And then when you're stuck, don't be afraid to work backwards. What's working right? What isn't? Am I displaying the good tone in there, right? Do I sound angry or do I sound optimistic? Do I show that I can be an influencer? So those are some key things. And the main thing to know is as you're going through it, focus on the problem, right? sometimes when you're talking about, as many people would say, the hardship essay, it becomes a trauma dump versus a despite it all story. If there has been some successful situations where you rose above, spend very, very little time, maximum, if any, a paragraph on what were the challenge during your high school years, but more about how you rose above. Help the reader see that, how you were open-minded, and then how are you use those learned experience to move forward. Those are something that's so important about that. And sometimes brainstorming could just be generating ideas with a close friend that really knows you. It can be, hold your breath, hold on. It may be that parent or guardian who's like, when you think about me, what are some things you think about, right? So what I'm going to do for you right now is, instead of just telling you different techniques, is I want you to get a paper or pen, or just close your eyes and think of these things. Everyone works in different ways. And I'm going to ask you some questions. And whatever those answers are, these are ideas that you can write about on your main personal statement. Are you ready? I'm going to give you a few moments there. And let's go. What are some ideas that matter to you? What are some ideas that matter to you? What is something a person said to you and you proved them wrong? What is something that someone said to you and you proved them wrong? How have you cleaned up a mess? How have you cleaned up a mess? What are ways you've illustrated never giving up? What are ways you have illustrated in your high school life never giving up? What's an unclear purpose you have? What's a vague or unclear purpose you have, and how will you be finding your way? How will you be finding your way? What is the biggest curiosity in your life? What is the biggest curiosity in your life? What is a negative experience that you turn positive, and how? What is a negative experience you have had and you turned into positive, and how? How have you shown your worthiness as a person? How have you shown your worthiness as a person? What is something that is important to you? And why? What is something that's important to you? And why? What was something that was really daunting, aka a challenge, and you face? What is something that was daunting or a challenge that you faced? So, as you come through all these different responses you made, circle one or two that really was important to you. If none of this activity has helped, just write three adjectives that best describes you. Are you creative, determined, passionate? And then again, show the reader, don't tell the reader. Keep the mindset. How are you showing yourself as you're checking your edits, that you're showing your impactfulness in the classroom, outside of the classroom, in the club, as a roommate, as a future alumni? Consider things that's important in your life, not long ago, high school life, and then how they shaped you, right? It could be your tennis shoes of being on the field, right? It could be a charm bracelet that's been important to you. Maybe it just life itself, and you know, or diversity. And then don't forget to outline, like making sure that it flows. You may use boxes to help you to see how do these ideas connect. And then ask yourself these key questions. This comes from the New York Public Library. What message do you want to come across to the admission counselors? Remember, is this in the best interest of the university or you? What does this example show about you? Right? So if they walk away, what are the three bullet notes or maybe one note they'll write down on your portfolio to the admissions committee? What details can you include about this example? Show the reader, don't tell the reader. You have to show them. You can't just say you're good, show you're good. You can't say you learned. You have to show them that you've learned. And what's the main theme you want to get across to the people regarding your statement? Is it that you have grit? You have innovation? You're compassionate? All the above? Yeah, remember, it doesn't have to be one thing. This is a statement. What presidential speech is only focuses on one thing, except vote for me. Yeah, vote for me in admissions. And how does each paragraph in your statement support your message? So those are things that you could kind of make sure, and that you want to avoid the mistakes of not focusing on yourself. You want to, again, don't tell, but show. Right. And then remember, this should be your positive story, not your negative story. Right. No drama dumps out there. There's other tips out there for you. U.S. News, College Essay Tips, College Board, Princeton Review. So many. There's podcasts for Inside the Admissions Office. So many more from the colleges and university. But the key thing is to start. Don't compare your writing to from other people. Oh, my God. So stressful. Just make sure you're you and have one person that's familiar with the admissions process, who knows you, that you can trust, because guess what? When it's personal statement, emphasis on personal, it could personally hurt the feedback. So sometimes when I even try to look my best and someone goes, oh, your hair is a mess. Oh, it hurts, right? Even though something superficial like one's hair, but someone's telling you because they care, and if they tell you in a respectful manner. So you got to get that mindset, have that courage to change what you can change, and then just put your statement out there. And we know that your statement does not determine your admissions. It's just a factor. It does not determine your worth. It doesn't determine exactly how well you will succeed in life, but it will determine how you will put in black and white how great you are. So be honest, not modest, and let's start writing. Good luck, everybody.
Thank you for listening to SI Counseling Podcast, where we help our students strive to respond courageously to the opportunities and challenges of our time.